Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss about photoelectric cartridges. The word photoelectric is a combination of two words, photo plus electric. So electricity which is produced due to light. So a photoelectric transducer is a transducer which converts light energy into electrical energy. You can see various types of photoelectric transducers around you, like solar cell, photomultiplier tube, photodiode, phototransistors, photoconductive cells. Now let us have a look at the classification of photoelectric transducers. So photoelectric transducers are broadly classified into two types, photodetectors and photoemissive. So in photoemissive devices, so when light falls on cathode, which is known as photocathode, electrons are emitted. So as these electrons are emitted due to photo, that is light, these electrons are known as photoelectrons, and the devices are known as photoemissive devices. So photoemissive devices can again further be classified into two types, photoelectric tube and photomultiplier tube. So photoelectric tube was before the advancement of semiconductor diodes. So now it has been replaced, it is no longer in use. In photomultiplier tube, the photoelectrons are multiplied by using several diodes. In photodetectors, the light is detected. So photodetectors are again of two types. So you can have photoconductive devices and photovoltaic devices. So photovoltaic devices means voltage is produced due to photon, that is light. So photovoltaic devices, familiar example is solar cell. When sunlight falls on the solar cell, you get an electric voltage. Then photoconductive cells. So in photoconductive type devices, the resistance of the material decreases when they are exposed to light radiation. In other words, their conductance or current in these devices increases when they are exposed to radiation. Photoconductive devices again can be of two types, bulk type and junction type. So bulk types generally consist of single layer of photosensitive materials with no p-n junction. But photo junction type can be of photodiode or phototransistor. So photodiode is nothing but a p-n junction diode with reverse bias. And phototransistor is a transistor which can detect the light and convert the light into electric voltage. Now, what are photoconductive cells? So, photoconductive cells are based on the simple principle that resistance of certain semiconducting material decreases when they are exposed to radiation. Means, the conductance of this material increases when light falls on this material, or the current in these devices increases when they are exposed to light. So, in photoconductive cells, we are first going to discuss about bulk type photoconductive cells, which are also known as photoresistor or light dependent resistors. So these photoresistors are made from single layer of photosensitive material and they have no p-n junction. The symbol for this photoconductive cell is shown in figure. Photoconductive cells are generally made from single layer of photosensitive material like cadmium sulfide, cadmium selenide, lead sulfide, thallium sulfide. A photoconductive cell generally consists of a ceramic substrate or base, thin layer of photosensitive material, metallic electrodes in order to connect the photocell to an external circuit, and for extra protection, a moisture radiant design may be needed. Now, over a ceramic substrate, a thin layer of photosensitive material is deposited in a zigzag manner, separating two metal coated areas which act as electrodes. Now the electrodes are arranged in a interdigital pattern so as to have maximum contact area with the photosensitive material. In this way it is possible to obtain a high ratio of dark to light resistance. Extra protection, the photocell can be enclosed in a metallic case with glass or plastic cover. Then photocells are available in various sizes, starting from 1/8 inch in diameter to 1 inch in diameter. When radiations of sufficient energy falls on photoconductive cells, they cause the electron to break away from the covalent bond, generating electron hole pairs. Now as the electron and hole pairs are created within the material itself, so they reduce the resistance of the material. An external power supply is needed to provide the direction and path for current to flow. The value of applied voltage may vary from few volt to several hundred volts depending on the types of photocell applications. The illumination characteristics of photoconductive cell is shown. So it is clearly visible that when not illuminated or when no light falls on the photocell, it has higher resistance, which is higher than 100 kilo ohm. This resistance is known as dark resistance. But when the cell is illuminated or when light falls on the photoconductive cells, its resistance can drop to only a few hundred ohms. The spectral response of cadmium sulfide cell, that is CDS cell, is similar to human eye. That is, it is sensitive to visible light. On the other hand, cadmium selenide, CDS cell, the spectral response is at longer wavelength of the visible region and extend into far infrared region. Both CDS and CDSE cell, both cadmium sulfide and cadmium selenide cell respond slowly to the change in light intensity. Cadmium sulfide cell has a response time of 100 milliseconds, where cadmium selenide cell has a response time of 10 milliseconds. So how photocell can be used for voltage regulation? So input voltage is given to a lamp and the light of the lamp is falling on the photocell, which is connected to a resistor and a external circuit. So when input voltage decreases, the lamp brightness will also decrease. So the resistance of the photocell will increase. So the output voltage V0, which is the product of the current and resistance, will be maintained constant.
Applications: photoconductive cells are used in counting applications, in detecting ships and aircraft, light meters, as an on-off switch, as volume control, and as voltage regulators.
Now let's discuss second type of photoconductive devices, that is junction type. So in junction type, we will first discuss photodiode. So what is a photodiode? So photodiode is nothing but a PN junction diode with reverse bias and is based on the same principle which is of that photoconductive cell. That is, when this PN junction bias is exposed to radiation or external light, its resistance decreases and current increases. The symbol for photodiode is shown in figure. The symbol is similar to a normal diode. Only exception is that light is falling, which will give you voltage. You can see the photodiode has been covered by a glass cover. So a glass lens has been used in the cap unit to allow maximum light to focus on the reverse bias junction. The active diameter of these devices is very small, only about 2.5 millimeter. But they are mounted in a TO type packages with a window to allow maximum incident light. Construction. So photodiode generally consists of a PN junction diode. P region consists of holes as majority charge carrier, electrons as minority charge carrier. N region consists of electrons as majority charge carriers and holes as minority charge carrier. We all know that when a PN junction is formed, a depletion region is formed. So a depletion region consists of immobile positively charged ion on one side and immobile negatively charged ion on another side. So this depletion region has a barrier potential or electric field is created inside the depletion region. Now, for this diode to become a photodiode, the diode should be connected in a reverse bias. So P region is connected to the negative terminal of battery and N region is connected to the positive terminal of battery. Now a lens is there, so which allows the light, maximum light, to fall on the reverse bias junction. So when light falls on the junction, that is the depletion region, covalent bonds are broken and electron hole pair is generated. Normally, when a PN junction diode is reverse biased, it has a very small reverse saturation current, which is due to thermally generated minority charge carriers, that is holes in N region and electrons in P region. But it is very small, in the order of nanoamperes. But what is a photodiode? Photodiode is nothing but a PN junction diode which is connected in reverse bias and light is falling on the reverse bias. So as the light falls on the junction in the depletion region, covalent bonds are broken, electron hole pairs are generated. So the minority charge carrier number increases and the current also increases. Means when light falls on photodiode, it will give you proportional voltage or current which is proportional to the intensity of incident. Now let us discuss the characteristics of photodiode. So the characteristics of photodiode are similar to the characteristics of diode in reverse bias. But what is makes the difference? The light makes the difference. So whenever there is no light, you will get a dark current. But as the intensity of light increases, say 10,000 lumen per meter square, reverse current also increases. Again you increase the intensity, say 20,000 lumen per meter square, again the reverse saturation current increases. So by changing the illumination, the level of reverse saturation current can be changed. A photodiode can turn its current on and off in nanoseconds. So what this makes it a First is photodetectors. So photodiodes are used in application where it is required to switch the light on and off at a very fast rate. The pin photodiode is a three-region reverse bias junction diode. The intrinsic silicon layer I is sandwiched between two heavily doped PN and type semiconducting material. So why it is done? It is so because the carriers generated by the light photons in the middle of the layer have less distance to travel than if they were generated on one side of layer or on another side of layer. So this makes the pin photodiode extremely faster or more faster than normal PN junction photodiode. And the relatively thick I layer, which is about 2.5 micrometer, ensures that almost all the light which is incident on the junction is absorbed. In pin photodiode, the reverse saturation current increases almost linearly with the level of illumination. Avalanche photodiode is a PN junction diode which operates in avalanche region. So what is the difference between normal PN junction photodiode and avalanche photodiode? The electron hole pair which are created by the incident light are accelerated by a very high electric field by achieving a photon multiplication of this carrier by a factor of nearly 50 and more. So these avalanche photodiode are also ultrafast diodes. Now let us discuss second type of junction photoconductive cells, that is phototransistor. So what is a phototransistor? Phototransistor is a bipolar transistor whose base is exposed to illumination, that is light. So phototransistor is similar to the ordinary transistor, but it has more base and collector areas. Phototransistors are available in both NPN and PNP type with different configurations like common emitter, common base, common collector, but common collector is mainly used. Then earlier phototransistors were made using materials like silicon, germanium, but nowadays modern components use semiconducting material like gallium, arsenide. Phototransistor is a three-layer semiconductor device in which a base is a light-sensitive region. So, phototransistor is manufactured in the same way as normal transistor, but only the base and collector areas are made large from the normal transistor because more light will incident, more current will be generated in the phototransistor consists of n-type substrates. So, into which collector, base and emitter are made by using diffusion and ion implementation technique. Earlier, phototransistors were made by using silicon and germanium, which was making a homogeneous structure. But nowadays, elements like gallium, arsenide are used to manufacture semi-phototransistor, which gives a heterogeneous structure and more conversion efficiency of light into electrical signal than that of homogeneous structure. Small hole is made on the collector surface of collector base junction and a lens is placed over the hole so that the maximum light can reach the collector base junction. Working of phototransistor. So the collector base junction is reverse bias and emitter base junction is forward bias. Base terminal can be left open for the incident light. When there is no light, the transistor is in darkness. Then there will be only very small reverse saturation current between the base and collector region, which will be due to minority charge carrier. Now, when light ray falls on the base region, electron hole pairs are generated and they are swept across by the electric field so that you will get an emitter current and the collector base current will be increased in the reverse bias mode, so the current will be amplified. Now, let us discuss the output characteristics of transistor, which is a graph of VCE, collector to emitter voltage, versus collector current IC. So, as you can see, when there is no light, the current is dark current, and as the intensity of light increases, the current through the phototransistor also increases.
Applications in car detection of both visible and invisible light, demodulation and switching, character recognition, logic circuit that requires stability and high speed, optical communication equipment and encoders.
Photoemissive photoelectric transducers. So in these types of transducers, when radiation falls on the cathode, which is known as photocathode, photoelectrons are emitted. So these devices are known as photoemissive devices. So let us discuss photomultiplier tube. Photomultiplier tube is a photoemissive photoelectric transducer. It is a photo tube in which current is amplified by electron multiplication through secondary emission. Photomultiplier tube consists of an evacuated glass envelope
In the glass envelope, there is a photocathode and several anodes, which are also called as dianodes, which are maintained at an increasing potential. When light enters in photomultiplier tube, it falls on photocathode and photoelectrons are emitted. Now, these photoelectrons are accelerated towards dianode number 1, as it is at higher potential than the photocathode. On colliding with dianode number 1, these photoelectrons liberate secondary electrons. Now, these secondary electrons are again accelerated or attracted towards dianode number 2, as it is at higher potential than dianode 1. Again, on striking dianode 2, these electrons again emit secondary electrons. These secondary electrons from dianode number 2 are attracted towards the dianode number 3, as it is at still higher potential than dianode number 2. So, the process of secondary emission continues till the emitted electrons are collected by the last dianodes or anode. And at each dianode, the secondary emission keeps on multiplying.
As photomultiplier tube has ultra-high sensitivity, low noise, extremely small dark current and very fast response time, which is less than 1 nanoseconds, they are extensively employed in scintillators, radiation monitors and detectors, space exploration, medical equipments, biotechnology, high energy physics experiments.
Now, let us discuss photovoltaic type photoelectric transducer. So, the word photovoltaic is a combination of two words, photo plus voltaic. So, in photovoltaic type photoelectric transducer, output voltage is produced due to the incident light and the output voltage is proportional to the intensity of incident light. So, in photovoltaic type photoelectric transducer, we will discuss our familiar solar cell. So, solar cell is nothing but a solar energy converter, or it is a PN junction diode which converts sunlight into electrical energy. The symbol for photo cell is shown in the diagram. Now, the difference between the photodiode and solar cell is that photodiode is a PN junction diode which is used with reverse bias, and solar cell is a PN junction diode without any bias. Construction and working. Solar cell consists of a PN junction which is packaged in a TO type can with a glass window on its top surface. The surface layer of P-type material is made very thin so that the incident light may easily reach the PN junction layer. The metal nickel ring at the P layer serves as the positive terminal, that is anode, and the metal contact at the bottom of N-type layer serves as a cathode. So, we know that a P-type material consists of holes as majority charge carrier and electrons as minority charge carrier, while N-type material consists of electrons as majority charge carrier and holes as minority charge carrier. When PN junction is formed, a depletion region is formed around the junction, which consists of a positively charged immobile ion on one side of the junction and negatively charged immobile ions on the other side of the junction, due to which a potential barrier or electric field is created across the depletion region. Now, when sunlight reaches the junction, it breaks the covalent bond, or it causes the electron to leave the parent atom and electron hole pairs are generated. External wire or resistance is connected to the solar cell, then these minority charge carriers, electrons and holes flow constitutes the current. This current is directly proportional to the illumination, which may be in lumen per meter square or milliwatt per centimeter. Silicon and germanium are the most widely used material for solar cell. But materials like gallium arsenide, indium arsenide and cadmium arsenides are also used for making solar cells. Let us discuss the VI characteristics of solar cell. So, VI characteristics of solar cell for different illuminations are shown in the figure. Let us consider the curve at illumination of 100 milliwatt per centimeter squares. So, here, if the cell is short circuited, means if both the terminals of the cells are directly connected, then you will get a maximum current which is 50 milliampere, but at that time voltage is zero, so your power is again zero. For an open circuit condition, when both the terminals of the cell are open, then you are getting maximum voltage which is 0.57 volt, but current is zero, so again the power output is zero. So for getting the maximum power output, the cell should be operated at the knee of the car.
Solar cells are used in powering space vehicles like satellites, in toys, watches and calculator, in rooftop solar panels, in solar heating. Solar cells are also used for transportation, in solar power plant and in solar remote lighting applications.